Dear students, welcome to our channel Online Class with Hema. In this video, we are going to see answers for English assignment set 2, unit 2. Prose, poem and supplementary. If you are seeing this channel for first time, don't forget to subscribe our channel. So, first one, prose lesson, a nice cup of tea. So, for synonyms, the first question is stimulation. The correct answer is option D. Excitement. Second one, the correct answer is option A, positive. Next, second subdivision, antonyms. First question, despised. That is third question. The correct option is B, liked. Fourth question, sufficient. The correct option is C, inadequate. Next, fifth question, in under suffix, the correct answer is option B, ly. Option B, ly. Next, preposition topic, Yuvan has been playing cricket. Well, the correct answer is since 2011. Okay, next, seventh one, trisyllabic word. The correct answer is option D, educate. For eighth question, fill in the correct option. So, the correct answer is option A, as neither Sudha nor Leela dash have been selected. The correct option is as. Next, ninth one, clipped word for perambulator. The correct answer is option A, perum. Next, tenth one, the correct answer is American word for queue. The correct answer is option C, line. Next, answer the following. What seems curious to the author? The correct answer is the best manner of making tea is the subject of violent disputes. It seems curious to the author. Next, second one, which tea does the author prefer? China tea or Indian tea? The author prefers Indian tea. Next, third one, what is the second golden rule in the preparation of tea? Tea should be made in small quantities in a teapot. The teapot should be made of china or earthenware. This is the second golden rule in the preparation of tea. So this is the answer for third question. Now fourth question. How does army tea taste? The correct answer is army tea is made in a cloudron, so it gives taste of grease and whitewash. Next, fifth question, why does the author advise removing cream from the milk? Milk that is too creamy always gives tea a sickly taste, so the author advises removing cream from the milk. Next, third subdivision, answer the following questions. What are the author's views on China tea? So this is the answer. China tea has qualities which are not to be disliked nowadays. It is economical. One can drink it without milk, but there is not much stimulation in it. One does not feel wiser, braver or more optimistic after drinking it. Next, second question, elucidate the author's idea about teapot. The teapot should be made of china or earthenware, silver or Britannia ware. Teapot produces inferior quality tea. Enamel pots are worse. Though curiously enough, a pitcher teapot, a rarity nowadays, is not bad. Next, third question. Whom does author call misguided people? What is his advice to them? So, one who adds sweetener to tea, the author calls them misguided people. He advised them to try drinking tea without sugar for a fortnight. They never want to ruin their tea by sweetening it again. So this is the answer for third question. Now fourth question. How does adding sugar affect the taste of tea? If we sweeten tea, we won't taste the tea. We are merely tasting the sugar. We could make a very similar drink by dissolving sugar in plain hot water. Thus, adding sugar affects the taste of tea. Next, fifth one. Does the author like drinking tea with sugar? Give reasons. No, the author does not like drinking tea with sugar. If we sweeten tea, we won't taste tea. We are merely tasting the sugar. Next, answer in detail question. Second one I have written first. So, summarize George Orwell's distinctive ideas in A Nice Cup of Tea. So, it is taken from the post A Nice Cup of Tea. Author is George Orwell. Theme is distinctive features of preparing a nice cup of tea. Characters. George Orwell, the narrator. Outline. Suggests 11 points. Indian or cyclonous tea. Small quantities. China or earthenware teapot. Pot be warmed beforehand. Strong tea. Tea powder put straight into pot. Add hot water with tea powder. Stir or shake it. Use breakfast cup. Pour the cream of the milk. Tea first, milk next. Drunk without sugar. So this is the chapter, this details outline. So we'll see the detail. George Orwell suggests 11 points to prepare a nice cup of tea. First of all, one should use Indian or cyclonous tea. Secondly, tea should be made in small quantities in a teapot. The teapot should be made of china or earthenware. Thirdly, the pot should be warmed beforehand. Fourthly, the tea should be strong. The author feels that 6 spoons would be enough for this. Fifthly, the tea powder should be put straight into the pot, otherwise it never infuses properly. Sixthly, one should add water with the tea powder while it boils in the kettle. Seventhly, after making the tea, one should stir it or give the pot a good shake. Eighthly, one should use a good breakfast cup which holds more tea. Ninthly, one should pour the cream of the milk before using it for tea. Milk that is too creamy always gives a silky taste. Tenthly, the author suggests that one should pour tea into the cup first and then add milk in the tea. Lastly, tea should be drunk without sugar. If we sweeten it, we won't taste the tea. We are merely tasting the sugar. These are the 11 golden points suggested by George Orwell. Next, first question. Discuss the 11 golden rules in the preparation of a nice cup of tea. So, first rule. One should use tea, Indian or cyclonous tea. Second rule. Tea should be made in pot of china or earthenware. Tea should be made in small quantities in a teapot. Next, third rule, the pot should be warmed before and. Fourth rule, the tea should be strong, so author suggests that 6 spoons of tea powder is enough. Next, fifth rule, tea powder should be put straight into the pot, otherwise it never infuses properly. Sixth rule, one should add water with tea powder while it boils in the kettle. Next, seventh rule, after making the tea, one should stir it or give the pot a good shake. Eighth rule, one should use a good breakfast cup which holds more tea. Next, ninth rule, one should pour the cream of the milk before using it for tea. Tenth rule, the author suggests that one should pour tea into the cup first and then add milk in the tea. 11th rule, tea should be drunk without sugar. If it's beaten tea, we won't taste the tea. If we sweeten it, we won't taste the tea. We are merely tasting the sugar. These are the 11 golden points suggested by George Orwell. Next, unit 2, poetry or Casuarina tree. So first one, one words. First one, the correct answer is option D, Casuarina tree. Second one, option B, giant. Third one, C, crimson. Fourth one, A, early. Fifth one, option A, water lilies. Sixth one, the correct option is C, habun. Seventh one, the correct option is creeper, option A. Next, ninth one, the correct option is D, python. Eighth one, the correct option is D, python. Ninth one, the correct option is D, kokila. 10th one, the correct option is B, personification. Next, answer the following. Why is the scarf colorful? Here the scarf refers to the winding creepers, flowers. They are colorful. Second one, how does the creeper appear on the tree? The creeper is winding. The trunk of the Casuarina tree round and round. It embraces the tree very tightly. Next, third one. Why is the Casuarina tree dear to poet's art? Casuarina tree is dear to the poet's art because she and her childhood friends played under the tree. Under that tree. How does the poet spend her winter? The poet spends her winter watching the baboon that sits like a statue on top of the tree. The offsprings run and play in the lower branches, the cows grazing and the water lilies springing in the pond. Next, fifth one, what does Wordsworth sanctified in this poem? Wordsworth was sanctified the yew tree of Borrowdale Valley in his poem. Next, answer the following. Third subdivision, the Casuarina tree will be remembered forever. Why? The Casuarina tree will be remembered forever because the poet expresses a wish that the tree should be remembered out of love and not just because it cannot be forgotten. Next, describe the garden during the night. So, answer is, during the night the garden is filled with an endless song. It is sung from the dark side of the garden. Next, third one, what does the poet convey through the expression in fear, trembling, hope? The poet conveys a human state of mind through the expression fear, trembling, hope. Next, fourth one, what does the poet convey through the expression? May love defend thee from the oblivion's curse. The correct answer is, here oblivion's curse means the curse of forgetfulness. The tree should be remembered out of love and not just because it cannot be forgotten. Next, fifth one, write about the monkey and its offspring in the Casuarina tree. So the answer is, the monkey sat on the top of the Casuarina tree like a statue. Its offspring sleep about and play in the tree's boughs. Next, answer in detail. The poet immortalizes the tree, elucidate. So this poem, the poem is or Casuarina tree, poet is told that the poet immortalizes the tree. Outline, Casuarina tree, dear to poet's heart, nostalgic memories communicate, tree laments, mortalizes you tree, remembered out of love. So the Casuarina tree is dear to poetist's art, not only for its impressive appearance but also for the nostalgic memories for her happy childhood that it brings to her. She strongly believes that nature communicates with human beings. The poetess could communicate with the tree even when she was in the far-off land. She could hear the tree lamenting her absence. The poetess consecrates the tree's memory. Consecrates the tree's memory to her loved ones who are not alive. She loves them above all. For their sake, she immortalizes the tree through this poem, like the poet Wordsworth, who sanctified the yew tree of Borrowdale Valley in its poem. She expresses her wish that the tree should be remembered out of love, and not just because it could be forgotten. So this is the answer for first detail. Next, second one, how does nature communicate with the poet? So the poem is our Casuarina tree. Poet or the tree, nature communicates with the poet. Poet outline Casuarina tree, dear to poet's art, nostalgic memories, communicate tree laminates, immortalizes you tree, remembered out of love. So the Casuarina tree is dear to poetess art, not only for its impressive appearance but also for the nostalgic memories of her childhood, happy childhood that it brings to her. She strongly believes that nature communicates with human beings. The poet could communicate with the tree even when she was in a far off land, as she could hear the tree lamenting over her absence. The poet consecrates the tree's memory to her loved ones who are not alive. She immortalizes the tree through her poem, like the poet Wordsworth, who sanctified the yew tree of Borrowdale Valley in his poem. She expresses her wish that the tree should be remembered out of love and not just because it cannot be forgotten. The poet was conscious of the fact that Casuarina tree was growing old. Taking inspiration from him, she decides to prevent her favorite tree from dying and passing into the irreversible world of oblivion. True to her fate, the tree lives on in our memories. As long as tongues can speak and eyes can see, one Casuarina tree will live in the hearts of millions of people till the end of the world. So we have completed the answers for Unit 2 poem. Now Unit 2 supplementary reader. For choose the correct answer for first one, the correct option is B, Hyena. Second one, option C, three. Fourth one, option A, Pondicherry. Fourth one, option B, Hyena. Fifth one, the correct option is C, water. Sixth one, the correct option is A, drum. Seventh one, Richard Parker. A, alcohol. For ninth one, the correct option is B, dog. For tenth one, the correct option is D, jungle. Next, describe the appearance of Richard Parker. So Richard Parker is a Mongolian tiger who is standing on the lifeboat with Pi when the ship sinks. Richard Parker lives on the lifeboat with Pi and is kept alive with the food and water Pi delivers. Second question, why Pi says that orange is the color of survival? In the life of Pi, the color orange symbolizes hope and survival. Just before the scene in which the Tissim sings, the narrator describes visiting the adult Pi at his home in Canada and meeting his family. Pi's daughter Usha carries an orange cat. Next, third one. While comparing himself with the tennis challenger, what Pi says to that player when he has nothing to lose in the game? The tennis challenger starts strong out, soon loses confidence in his playing. The champion racks up the games, but in the final set, when the challenger has nothing left to lose, he becomes relaxed again, insouciant, daring. Suddenly, he is playing like the devil, and the champion must work hard to get those last points. Next, fourth question, the correct answer is Pi was thirsty and his throat was parched. He was going from place to place in his life, both to find out water. Finally, he saw many tins of water just below the tarpaulin. He slowly moved towards that, took three tins and quenched his thirst. Next, fifth one, the correct answer is because without Richard Parker, he would not be alive. Next, third subdivision, first question. Pi became an orphan. He was hanging on an oar. He had a tiger in front of him and sharks beneath him. A violent storm was bragging about him. Next, second question. Richard Parker was a 450-pound Bengal tree. Pi thought that such a huge animal could not withstand thirst and hunger. Next, third question. In the face of such a superior predator, all of them were prey and normal ways of preying were affected. It seemed the presence of a tiger had saved me from a hyena, surely a textbook example of jumping from frying pan into the fire. So this is the answer for third question. Next, fourth one. The lifeboat was 3.5 feet, 8 feet wide and 26 feet long. The lifeboat was designed to carry 32 people. Everything in the lifeboat was painted orange. It had tarpaulin, life jackets, life buoy and oars. The word Simpson and Panama were painted on either side of the bow in black Roman capital. This is the answer for fourth question. Next, fifth one. Pi was suffering from thirst. His throat was parched. He went from place to place to find water. Finally, he found tins of water under the tarpaulin. With some difficulty, he opened. The tins and drank water. He was delighted and it brought him hope, surprise, disbelief, thrill and gratitude. Next part, the first question. Answer is lesson. Life of Pi. Author is Jan Martel. Theme, adventure on a lifeboat. Genre, extended tale. Character, Pi Patel, struck stranded in ocean. Richard Parker, Bengal tiger. So, Life of Pi by Jan Martel is a fantasy which describes the incredible experience of a young man who survives a dangerous ordeal in the sea. The story was made into a film in the year 2012 with the publication of Life of Pi in 2001. Martell became internationally famous. Next, Pi Patel is an Indian boy from Pondicherry. He survives 227 days after a shipwreck while stranded on a lifeboat in the Pacific Ocean with a Bengal tiger named Pi was stranded in the Pacific on a... As he looked around, he was shocked to find Richard Parker on board. He was pinned by weakness, having had no food, water or even sleep for nearly 3 days. Strangely, his thirst overpowered his fear of Richard. Parker, he went about exploring for fresh water. His search for water took him dangerously close to Richard Parker, but nothing could stop him. Neither Richard Parker nor the hyena. A little later, he succeeded in his search when he found stacks of can of drinking water. Pi come back to life and his senses after drinking the exclair of water. Then he realized that Parker, who scared him earlier, brought him peace, prosperous and wholeness. He understood that it was Richard Parker who helped him to survive for 227 days. Pi left Richard Parker in the jungle and reunited with his family. So the quote for this detail is, water is the exclair of life. Next, second question, Life of Pi is an abridged version of the famous novel titled Life of Pi, written by Jan Martell. Pi was on his way to Canada with his father, mother and animals to his zoo. But unfortunately, the ship was wrinkled and Pi escaped in lifeboat. In the same lifeboat, he had a tiger named Richard Parker, an orangutan, a zebra and a hyena. At the end, he was left with the tiger. Parker's presence was a protection for him from other animals. It behaved as if it was seeded and it suffered from sickness. Other animals were silent because of the fear of the bigger animal. Pi accepted the Parker, claimed him down. He said, That one who scared him bought him peace. He wanted to tame him. His attitude was that the tiger should die first. But suddenly he realized that part of him loved the tiger. He did not want to be left alone, so he wanted to live with the tiger. So we have completed the answers for assignment 2. Unit 2, English. So if you are seeing this channel for first time, don't forget to subscribe our channel. Thank you.